just came here to win. I just came here to end. I just came here to fight. Show you everything you said I couldn't be. I became overnight. This is for the blood, this is for the tears, this is for my pain and my plight. Two are good, but only one of us is walking out of here tonight. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life.
Smashing her fucking face in.
Hi guys, I'm Andrea Jane, also known as AJ Bunker. You may know me from Love Island Season 7 as being a bombshell, or you may not, because I was only there for a week. You may even know me for my last minute fight with Elbrook. Welcome to my journey. So I first got into the crossover boxing scene when I was approached for Box Star. At the time when I first got approached, I was like, no way, no chance. I don't want to get my face punched in. I've never fought before, so it's just not going to be me. However, I was drinking so much when I left Love Island. I was going to so many events and I was just on a downward spiral and just on a warpath with my own mindset and body. So I thought, right, let's go to one training session and see what it's like. And after that first crack on the pads, I fell in love with the sport. Sadly, after 4 weeks of training, Boxstyle was cancelled. And I was then, I think 2 months later, approached for Celeb MMA. And again, I was like, why not? I love the combat sports, something I want to try. And yeah, so that's where that began. So my Celeb MMA opponent was a girl called Carla Howell. From day one, that girl was an absolute cretin, which made it easier because obviously I had to fight her and I really just disliked her from the get-go. So I was like, it makes it easier for me to want to choke the bitch out, basically. And there was just quite a bit of drama that came from that. She started trolling me, her sister started trolling me. She got really like verbally abusive online. And it's like, okay, look, I get you got to build a fight, but you're just making it so personal. And then I guess it really got personal at the press conference.
Carla, how or Carla who? I've never heard of you, honey.
Are you seeing my competition or should I say what competition? I'll let her keep running.
I am training hard.
Everyone need to train hard.
Everyone's
you
seen
need
it.
To
I
fucking train.
Hold on, hold on.
I train. Tag me in your little Instagram stories, bitch.
I don't start fights, my
okay, honey.
So at the press conference, obviously we both brought a bit of smoke. It was a little bit back and forth. And then when it came to the face-off, I gave her a little push. You know, just a little, nothing too major. Then the bitch decided to scratch my face and kick my fanny. Then shortly after the press conference, Celeb MMA was also canceled. I was then approached to fight Elbrook with 2 weeks notice, which at this time I thought was absolutely mad. But I had been training and been going in and out of fight camps as obviously from the beginning of the year. And I was like, I really want to get ring experience. Whether I win or lose, I just want to see if I actually like being in the ring. Because whether I'm wasting my time doing all these fight camps for it to not go anywhere.
First, to make her way into the arena, AJ Bunker. And now, please welcome her opponent, Elbrook!
They've done exactly that. There's no loser in this fight. I'm telling you now, there's no loser in this fight.
By unanimous decision, Elbrook!
I then lost, which was inevitable when you come in with 2 weeks' notice, when you've been practicing for an MMA fight. I think actually, when you watch that fight back, I think I even tried to grab her in a headlock. I tried to kick her. I was just basically conditioned for an MMA fight and not boxing. I even was very like square on, not in a boxing stance. But I'm glad I had that experience and I literally was like, I do want to do this again. Right, so after all of that, I was then approached to fight Astrid on Misfits 02. But then obviously she then got a new opponent, which was Keely, which made more sense at the time because they had more beef. Me and Astrid never even spoken. So it was fine, because I then brought in my Celeb MMA opponent, Carla.
So, first day of camp. First day of camp, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling good, I'm so excited. So good to be back in the boxing gym. I've definitely got still the same passion, I love it, I'm loving the combat sport. Obviously got like 4 weeks to get prepared for this fight, so a little bit longer than my last fight. Yeah, just bring it on, I'm ready. I just can't wait to knock Carla's head off as well. Obviously, I'll do the Celeb MMA, like we're going in, train hard.
Yeah, look, they said that I couldn't do it, so I went and did it. Y'all think it's only a moment. Top of the world, the globe is spinning. No, you know, I've been on mission. Okay, let's get it. Got a little time on my hands like a wristwatch. I don't got time for the breaks and the pit stop. Race to the gridlock, take it like Chris Rock. Right to the chest, the wind, heavy metals like slip.
Stand here, Ash. It's a long night for people if that jab hand and that footwork is in sync the whole time. Sting them. There. Take one out, yeah? Grind them away. Grind them away. Grind them away. Start again. Change the angle fast.
Yeah.
Yeah? It's like, it's no difference to this standard. It's no different to the ball in the matador. That ball comes stinging through. Where's it going? It's going one way. That matador. Change the angle. Pop, pop, pop. Yeah? The jab has everything. Every shot comes off the jab.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you're flushing it through. It's there. Bang, bang, bang. Pepper it, pepper it. It's too close. Boom, boom.
So we've got DAZN coming in for filming today. It's for the promo shots, a bit of behind the scenes. So exciting day. So yeah, I think yeah, it's all feeling real now. It feels like this. I think this is it. Once this, I think it hasn't really hit me. Once we start filming and start seeing it all happening, then yeah.
This is like teaching a toddler how to wrap hands. Go on.
AJ, media day.
Media day today with DAZN.
Cameron Campbell.
Ash catch them all.
Ash catch them all.
Ash catch them
all. Ash catch them all. What, crabs?
Catch them all.
Yeah, no, we've got to catch all the influences, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Collector's item. What's it about?
Yeah.
Easy work.
Taylor first, Salt Happy next.
Training there, hard work stays in there, fight nights are easy nights. Well.
Hey, there's a reason why I just back to my just for talking.
Yeah, I'm
Hi, I'm Andrew Jane, also known as AJ Bunker, and this is Misfits Season 2. No, Misfits 2.
Misfits Boxing 2.
For me, it was actually just to enhance my lifestyle and just give me a bit more motivation and give me something to focus on. And then as soon as I started training, I just fell in love with the sport. I just felt, as soon as I had that first crack on the pads, basically, I was like, this feels good, I love it. I hate the gym, but I love training for boxing and combat sports for some reason. So, yeah, I fell in love with it. Okay, so that's a wrap for Media Day. That's so awkward at the interview. That's a wrap for Media Day.
Try it one more time.
So, fight week. My opponent pulled out or didn't sign a contract. Basically, she pussied out. So, no fight anymore, which is really gutting. It's actually quite heartbreaking because I was actually really looking forward to first getting a W, secondly, looking better in the ring, and thirdly, smashing her fucking face in.
What's next plans?
Next plans is potential new fight in November, and in terms of with Misfits, I just want to take on the winner out of Astrid and Keeley, so I'll be calling that out on Saturday. I will still be training off camp. I've fallen in love with the sport, so for me, yeah, I want to continue training, I want to keep taking over. And you know how it is in this influencer fight world as well, you just never know when an opportunity arises, so I just want to be ticking over, I'm ready. So if a last minute new fight comes along, I'm ready to just jump in the ring and be like, yeah, I'm good to go.
So obviously she pussied out, but I then got called back by Celeb MMA under a new name called Rage Combat to fight my friend Tasha Kieran. I'm not gonna lie, when I was first told that I was gonna fight my friend, it was quite messed up. Like, I went through fight camp with Tasha, fell in love with that girl. She ended up becoming one of my really good friends.
at the same time, I was like, we both are owed money from Celeb MMA, so this is a way to do it. And I've been training for a boxing fight, and I wanted to put my skills into use and be like, I want to just see that I've got better. So I was just like, fuck it, let's do this. And we both agreed. We were like, look, it is what it is. We are friends, but what it is in the ring, we're going to come for blood and it's going to be a war, but we will be friends afterwards. But the main issue was, is that Tasha weighed a lot more than me and I was a lot less. So we both had to agree to meet in the middle at 55 kg, which for me, being half Filipino and having crazy weird metabolism I have, was a struggle. I ended up having to get a nutritionist. Shout out to Sam Lawrence. I ended up having to eat 3,500 calories a day. I was actually eating like pizzas, McDonald's, chocolate, pan of chocolates, whatever you want to call them, leading up to my fight, which felt unnatural when you're training for a fight and trying to be healthy, but you're eating like a pig. But I did make my weight, so it was amazing. So my main coach is Luke Groves. He is incredible. He's like an annoying big, actually he's not even big, he's like an annoying brother basically that you don't want but you love, like you just have a love-hate relationship with him. He has been incredible. He actually started coaching me from back when Boxstar, so he's seen me go throughout that journey. Even with Celeb MMA, when I weren't training boxing, he still had me come in and help me with my striking, and I just love that guy so much. So yeah, Luke, although you piss me off a lot, I love you and I appreciate you so much. I also had the amazing Tom, not so little. He looked after me when Luke was on a 3-week cruise when I was leading up to a fight. But yeah, I really, really appreciate Tom Little coming in and just being amazing and just spending that time with me. He is such a great guy.
Today we are in Bushy. Luke's away for 3 weeks, so got the lovely Tom Little, not so little, helping me today. We had a late night session last night and we're just getting on it again today, so he's keeping me working whilst Luke's away. So very, very much appreciate him. I'm very grateful that he's coming and seeing me, because I felt a little bit lost not working on the pads and bags. Whilst Luke's been away, so yeah.
It's the classic, it's classical gold art. Urban blacksmith, black is the Mozart.
Good, isn't he? Beautiful chin.
That's
a good one.
That's a good
one. I'm sorry.
Not into that sort of stuff, you know? I'm not into that. Some guys pay for that. Not a bit of me, that. See that?
Yeah.
That's something that will work. We drill that one more time, yeah? I think that's something that you just took to straight away.
Yeah. Rush, rush,
rush. And also a special mention to Saz from Saz Fitness, or SAS Fitness. Guys, I can't remember, I don't have to pronounce it. I hope I got it right. With him, Halal Ham and Salt Pappy, you boys honestly were amazing. In my local area as well, Luton Hockwell like ring, like it was amazing. Like you guys put me through my paces and I appreciate you lot so much.
This is Dev, everyone. He's been my strength and conditioning coach.
Yep, just putting some serious work and getting the power into her. You know, to get to see some knockout punches.
That's it. I've known a lot of explosive training. I'm loving it.
You ready?
Floor seats for the Knicks. Couple models blowing hits. They don't even want to pick. Want to lick up, want to... Yeah! I done made a couple hits. Going hammer with the pick. God handed me the gift. Not the slammer for a brick. Yeah! Yeah! Rollie ain't got a tick. I attract a lot of dicks. Getting caught up in.
I did. For passion. Ah. Obviously, you'll be sick.
Completed it after this. Well done. Well done.
I'm done. Got a fork in me, I'm done. This man's gonna kill me.
To be fair, these people that don't take you seriously, all they're doing is, you know, they're sort of damaging their reputation by not putting the work in their fitness. What she's doing here, she's putting so much on the line, and she's putting so much work in. She's boxing, she's coming to the gym, she's swimming, she's running, she's doing everything she can. You know, you've got to take a hat off to her.
And as I said, like, people think influencers just don't put the graft in. This is proving we actually do. We're not just here to look pretty, we're here to put the work in, so.
Exactly what you're doing.
I feel like I'm gonna die. I'm proud, honestly, after the first round, I was like, I don't know how I'm gonna do it.
Yeah.
Honestly, it's like that. After that first.
When you get to round three, you think, that's it, game over.
After round one, I was like, this is it.
But after that, it doesn't get any worse. You're already feeling at your worst there. Yeah. So therefore, you just have to fight through and get through. It's exactly the same when you're in that boxing match.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That first round's gonna be relentless and that. So you have to take your time in that. And then the fitness is gonna take control of that match. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. And you're gonna be well prepared for that. Yeah?
So, Tash, I'm coming for you, babe. I'm sorry. But you're definitely not putting the work in, I'm putting in. That's facts.
And I honestly would not have been able to do any of this without Dev, my S&C coach. That guy is incredible. He is like the sweetest man you'll ever meet, even though he puts me through the most grueling sessions. But he is incredible, guys. And anyone who's done full base and wants to get fit or lose weight or just, he's incredible, hit him up. Honestly, hit him up. So for this bike camp, I've trained with Anna, Shana, Ashley, Ramiz, Ryan Lovegrove, Salt Pappy, Halal Ham. Honestly, you guys have been incredible. And although we're beating the crap out of each other most of the time, it is just one big boxing family. That's what I love so much. And there's been so many other people as well, just like the LG boxing community and gym that I haven't mentioned, but you guys know who you are. And yeah, I couldn't have done it without you guys.
Give me something. Where are you going to hit her? Are you going to slap her?
Straight in the kisser, baby.
No, I love Tash as well, but girl, I'm going to smash you up.
Smash her!
My God, fight week. First of all, the press conference went off. I don't know if you guys have seen the press conference, but Little Man and Tune. But fight week was good. Like, we always said the press conference. And actually, that's where I kind of saw another side to Tasha. Like, she is my mate, but I knew we were both coming for, like literally we wanted to win. And I didn't know at that point whether she would bring it or not. But at the press conference, I was just like, damn, this girl is actually meant to be my friend, but we are bringing it. So something you guys didn't know is after the press conference, I got extremely ill, like to the point of having the worst cold that I couldn't even get out of bed. I was so fatigued. I couldn't breathe out of my nose. My throat was closed up. I honestly didn't know what I was going to do because I was like, I've had so many cancelled fights. This one's finally going to go ahead. And I was scared I was going to have to pull out.
All right, guys. So, official weigh-ins this morning. So,
package for real.
Let's see where we're at.
And now stepping on the scales, we have AJ Bunker.
AJ Bunker weighs in at 55 kg.
Whoa.
Until it's all done.
Good.
Lovely.
And now we have stepping on the scales, Tasha Kieran.
Tasha Kieran weighed in at 55.1 kg.
Yes! So, the morning of the fight, I woke up. And I'm telling you now, my prayers must have worked the night before because I woke up, I was still ill, but I could actually breathe out my nose. So I was like, right, okay, I feel like, I don't know if it was adrenaline, but something made me feel like I'm still ill, but I've got enough strength for me to get through today and get this fight done. So I was just, first of all, feeling so happy that I felt well enough to do it and I didn't have to pull out. And secondly, I was just excited and ready to just go. I'm feeling nervous and just everything, just, it was just all the emotions. So the car journey to the fight, I honestly went through like a mix of emotions. First of all, I was like, how am I supposed to fight my friend? How am I supposed to punch my friend in the face? Someone I actually care and love and like potentially could break her nose. Well, what if we fall out after this because of it? Secondly, I was like, I want the win. I really want this win. There was so much pressure because of what happened after the Elle Brooke fight and how bad that fight was. And I was just like, I want to win. I want to look like I'm taking this seriously. And I want to look like a good competitor in the women, like in the women's side of crossover boxing. So there was so much pressure and there was so much mixed emotions, plus feeling sick just from nerves. So yeah, it was a mad hour drive to the venue.
Hello, hello, hello,
hello, hello, sexy banana.
It's red in here, isn't it?
Oh,
look at that, I feel like I'm in the red light district.
Like a fist.
Really, really. You're gonna pat him with a.
You alright?
I'm late, darling.
Okay, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling good.
You look healthy, not ready.
Ready to go, baby. Ready to rumble.
You had any words
to
Tash?
Good luck, baby.
Is that
what
we can say?
No, not for us. You had any
words?
Before this fight? Oh, yeah. Look, we're all good, but it's not that room, so.
Yeah,
not that room. It's going to be a fight.
Do you know what? I'm excited to smash heads with my friend. All the mixes, do you know what? I'll be honest, the most exciting part is the end where we can have a fucking shot and we can party, baby. Ain't that right?
That's right, baby, that's right. That is right.
Listen, this is interesting. Two friends going head to head.
Feeling good, we're just gonna have a little play around, cool them up a little bit, try the gloves on. Feeling
alright. Stepping into the ring, honestly, I can't even tell you, like, adrenaline just took over. I don't even remember doing my walkout, I just remember seeing Tasha, hearing Luke, and seeing Luke, and just hearing the bell go.
I didn't feel unfit, even though I suffered with a cold yesterday. It was so bad. I lost my contact, my eye, and I went actually all right. I'm trying to get better now. Go back in the boxing.
Good.
Like, work on it. Come on, Donnie, without you. Love that.
Strap season, baby.
Strap season, right, strap
top. Let's go and cut them wraps off.
I won the fight, and honestly, guys, I cannot believe it because, first of all, I was dealing with a serious bad cold the day before. And I don't know if you saw the fight, but I lost my contact lens 20 seconds in. So I actually was blind in one eye. Somehow, magically, I won the fight. And then having my best friends there as well, I know that my two best friends who came to that fight, they hate seeing me fight. They hate seeing me get punched, but they always make it to my fights. And just seeing how, like, coming out of the fight to them and seeing their reactions and them just being there just meant the world to me. Seeing my mum's reaction and my dad's reaction after the fight just meant the world to me. Like, my mum, honestly, when I first told my parents I was getting into boxing, I didn't know how they were going to take it, but my parents have been so supportive. My mum, I feel like I saw tears in my mum and dad's eyes, and it just meant the world to me. So my plan for 2023, I want to get back on a Misfits card. I'm coming back for you guys, baby, and I want the Astrid fight to happen. That's if Astrid's not too pussy and scared. She had a really easy fight with Keely. She didn't have to go all rounds. So I want that fight to happen. It was originally meant to happen. I want that fight. I want Misfits to make that happen. So Misfits, if you see this, make that fight happen. And I basically want the first female Misfits bantamweight belt. 2023, be ready.